प्रसन्न धरणी, गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. सो धरणी सो फार फ्रॉम द ईयर 2015-16 इज नॉट एट ओवर. दिस इज द हाईलाइट, फाइनेंशियल हाईलाइट. इनिशियली धरणी व्हेन इट वाज रजिस्टर्ड एज मैक्स इन 2008, बिफोर 2008 देयर वर ऑपरेशंस स्टार्टेड विद हेल्प ऑफ वन ऑफ द कोऑपरेटिव्स प्रमोटेड बाय टिम्बक्टू कलेक्टिव. The name of the cooperative is Adishakti. That time it was named as Adishakti Dharani. So the initial capital was put forward by Adishakti about 2.5 lakh. Then 2006 to 2010, that is a year, almost 4 years, Dharani tried to learn how to procure, how to process. That time entirely bulk trading. The value addition, now it is different state. But that time it was just procuring groundnut, selling groundnut, no oil, no peanut, nothing. Just buying groundnut, selling groundnut, because that time the experience to do all that was not there. Timbuktu Collective is trying to do things. So in 2010-11 or further till now, what we are doing is, we are converting the raw material, adding value and storing till we get a good price. That is the entire formula to get this Dharani success. So in case of 2010-11 and 11-12, the losses in the first 4 years, about 2.5 lakhs was completely recovered. So 2010-11, first year where Dharani made profit. But still there were losses, cumulative losses. That also covered in 2011-12. The most important thing to happen in 2012 and 13 is sharing of profits between the from the cooperative to farmers. That was done based on the patronage. Patronage in the sense, those who are sold, they only get the profits. And the profits are distributed based on the number of kgs. Example, for millet, 1 kilo millet, 5 rupees is the bonus. For 1 kilo of groundnut, 1 rupee is the bonus. For 1 kilo of paddy or ragi, 2 rupees is the bonus. So the incentive system is created to those crops which are economically and also ecologically sustainable. Not just cash crops, not just a crop which gives you immediate profit, but long term. So that is the economic incentive system cooperative has adopted. Because of that, more and more farmers have come forward to sell it to Dharani, particularly millets. There are other farmers who are not members of the Sangha. They are also willing to sell it to Dharani because of the system. But we are not buying from them because we need to establish a system where they are part of the organic sanghas. Then agriculture exchange services have to be extended to them. There has to be caterers, all that. We cannot invest on those things at present. So we are not allowing them to avail services from cooperative because we can't do that. Over a period of last 3 years, we have shared profits of 13 lakhs rupees with the farmers. Not only with the farmers, we have also shared profits with the staff and also daily wage laborers. Daily wage laborers are rate of 10 rupees per day. Because everybody has their own share in this entire activity. So we wanted to share equitably with all. So I have, just in one slide I have explained what Dharani is doing. So this graph is about the procurement quantity over a period of last 9 years. In 2006-07 you can see Dharani has purchased only 50,000 kgs. But now 2015-16 till yesterday, it has purchased 3 lakh kgs, almost 300 tons. The maximum it has purchased is 3 lakh 61 kgs in 2013-14. So if you see those 2 years, last 2 years, there is no jump like this. There is a stability, if you can see. It is because we do lot of planning, crop planning. Based on the rain, based on the availability of water with those farmers who have irrigated facilities, basically borewell, sprinkler and all. So we recommend these crops which Dharani buys. Because of that planning, there is a stability in procurement. Almost 300 tons every year it is coming, last 3 years. That stability is giving Dharani lot of things. So this graph is about procurement and sales in Dharani. Procurement value, sales value. You see in the beginning of this year, this is procurement, this is sales. In the first 4 or 5 years, if you see, 1 year procurement and sales is almost same. Another year, procurement is high and sales is low. If your procurement is high and sales is low, will you make profit? You will not make profit, no? But if you see the last 4 or 5 years, procurement is less, sales is high. So this gap is increasing. That's why Dharani is getting profit. So the experience of Dharani dealing in value-added products, millets, conversion from groundnut to millets, conversion from bulk to retail, all that has helped in getting profits. So this slide is about the value chain, and this is about the foxtail millet rice. 1 kilo rice is sold at 100 rupees MRP. We sell through the retailers. We means Dharani. So Dharani sells the retailers at 75 rupees. So retailers keeps 25 rupees margin for his or her services. Then they pay to 75 rupees to Dharani. Dharani keeps 19 rupees to take care of its expenses, taxes, all that. Then it pays to farmer 56 rupees. This is the Dharani value chain. On an average, for every 100 rupees, 56 rupees is going to farmer. But if you take any vegetable value chain or any other thing, where water is used, the most of the water is used to produce vegetables and fruits, they get only 10 rupees to 15 rupees in a 100 rupee, which is paid by consumer, either pomegranate or tomato or any other. So in this way, this is more better value chain than the normal value chain. The doubt farmers had is, they get for raw material 30 rupees, bonus 35. So how it becomes 56 rupees for a kg of rice? So then I explained, for 1 kg of millet rice, we need 1 kilo 600 gram of raw material. So 1 kilo 600 gram into 35 rupees will be almost 56 rupees. So these are all our plans. Almost we are estimating that we are supplying good clean food to almost 30,000 customers all over South India, basically, through 244 retailers. Retailers, direct consumers. But we have developed a lot of innovative products, and also price also compared to other market players, it is less. But compared to normal traditional product, it's more. Next. A question may come to you, what is the benefit to farmer? But the benefit, if you see, it's not just by only selling, there are many things. I will try to explain one by one. The cost of cultivation is reduced by 30% to 40% for a 5-acre, say, millet farm, if you switch from groundnut. This is because of seed cost and also organic methods. There is no need for pesticides. We are assuming per acre 10,000 rupees is the groundnut cultivation cost. So if you, for 5 acres, there will be 50,000 rupees. But for a millet farming, for 5 acres, it will be only 20,000 rupees. That is our record. We have farmer dairies based on that. That is the cost of cultivation. So you straight away save, if you have 5 acres, 30,000 rupees, because you don't need seed. Millet seed is very less costly. And also you don't need pesticides, other things. But you have to prepare organic concoctions, Jeevamrita Mandal. That's what I am saying. Jeevamrita Mandal, farmer has to prepare. So in organic farming, there is no fertilizer, there is no pesticide.
That you say, huh?
Yeah.
You are saying only pesticide.
Both. Fertilizer and pesticide, both. So fix the price before this season. So before that, there is one more thing. Correct weighing practices. We do not cheat on weight, you could have seen in the video. But many people do not agree to our statement. But there is a happening in our district or all over AP, there is no weighing at all in agriculture trade. Government is supposed to see, but government doesn't have enough staff to take over so many acres. We have 20 lakhs acres. Trading between 7 lakhs farmers to few traders, who is monitoring? There is no weighing at all. There are some of farmer friends here. They also do trading. They know. It's all only lot. 10 bags into converted into 7 bags. 7 bags of trader bags, 10 bags of farmers. No weighing happens. But in Dharani, exact weighing happens. Even a small kid can see how many kgs it is. So we are estimating there is 25% saving for farmers. That is our only perception. Third one is fixing the price. We fix the price for millets and pulses. Like Asgram, we told, we have promised to farmer that 20 rupees, at the 20 rupees per kg we purchase. We purchased 30 tons. The last production was only 4 tons. So millets almost 30 rupees. Even there are 2 millets with 35 rupees per kilo. Over and above this, there will be 5 rupees bonus. How we are able to provide this fixed price, that we will discuss later. But that's what we are offering to farmer. Fixing the price before even you purchase your seed. We fix the price in April. Then cooperative promise to buy all that farmers produce. Like in April, we get a plan, crop plan. So we offer that. As per the plan, we will buy. We don't need to worry. So we never say to a farmer, "We our godown is full. We cannot market. You sell it in the market." That when we are going to tell that statement to farmer, that is the day the cooperative is going to fail. That is the first day you can count, cooperative will fail. So we are not saying whatever quantity you produce as per the plan. They would have given 10 acres. So whatever comes from the natural nature rain, we buy all that. So we do not go back on our promise. Then premium prices, 5 to 10% organic. But this is very humble statement. If you know, I was discussing with one of the AF person. The farmers of AFF sold millets, Korra, Foxtail millet and all, at 20 to 22 rupees. But we are paying 30 rupees. You can see what is the percentage organic premium. Then there is over and above, there is a quality food, quantity food available for farmers. And there is incentive, 3 to 7% as a incentive at the end of the year. Overall for 5 acres, excluding the availability of food, 22,500 created by reduction in expenses and also additional income. For 5 acres, every season, if the farmer has irrigation facility, they can gain by 2 times. So additionally, 45,000 income is possible if they are part of this cooperative society, if they do organic farming. 5 acres. Thank you.
What is the demand? Are you able to meet that demand, 300 tons you are selling now?
Sir, we have demand up to even 1,000 tons we can sell. Because the demand is coming from not only towns and big cities. It is coming from Anandapur. It is coming from Dharmavaram. It is coming from Penagondu. In AP, 20 lakhs people are affected by diabetes. We have only 4 crore population. And all the doctors are recommending millets. Not just millets, eat good food. Clean, fair food. Because the food is contaminated in the market. That is the basic problem for both diabetes and cancer.
So are you getting bigger price only because of organic, or can you not get the same price with less
fertilizer? See, the thing is, it's not just about only organic, but organic gives you all what you call the entry, and also it helps you build the brand. There are people who sell millet without organic in our own district. They get only 65 to 70 rupees. We are able to sell at 100 rupees in Anandapur. So organic gives you the moral stand and it is going to farmer. These are the two important things.
It's not just millets, no? It's also pulses, it's also peanuts, groundnut and groundnut oil. So it's not that we are only selling, or the Dharni is only selling millets. Also its main profit actually comes from peanuts.
He asked about what is the future plan to, because we are not allowing others to join us. So how are we going to scaling up?
First of all, scaling up is not our business. Scaling up is the government's business. Or we should be Reliance. No, we are not Reliance. We are farmers cooperative. So how much the farmers can handle, that's much how much we can do. We cannot do more than that. And it should be governable by the farmer. So So if it was only me running it, if I am the sole owner and proprietor of that, then maybe I would have tried to make a Reliance. But I am not. And our whole principle is to do farmer-producer cooperatives, that the profits must go to the farmer, that it should be local. So we are talking about local economy, and we are not talking about international economy and just profits. So that's the difference, and therefore scaling up will be very slow because the investment required for scaling up is huge. You have seen our per farmer cost is huge. And that's the kind of investment that is actually needed if you don't want to just make profit. If you want that the farmer's whole life is dealt with, then the investment is a lot.
I agree with you. Scaling up is the responsibility of the government. So now state government is planning to promote 130 clusters in the states. Each district 10 clusters, 10,000 members. Now under RKVI they are going to promote. Having rich experience in the promotion of organic clusters, what Dharani is going to contribute or suggest strategies and policies to the government? That would be great contribution to the state.
So Dharani is a business enterprise. And Dharani will do anything only for profit. So if it is profitable for Dharani, it will help. If it is not profitable for Dharani, it will not help. Simple. Okay? So, but Timbuktu Collective is a social service organization. So Timbuktu Collective will help. But because Timbuktu Collective also needs to earn money, and is not ready to do free service for the government, which is its work. If they pay us, we will do it. Yeah, but expertise doesn't come free. And we have over 100 farmers who are trained. They are trained trainers who can train both in cooperative building and in farming and in medicine, you know, yeah, organic inputs. And they are well-trained, highly skilled farmers. There are over 100 of them. So if the government wants and is ready to pay them, we are willing to help the government.
Government అంతేగాని పైన ఏదో వాళ్ళు ఏదో చేస్తున్నారు ఆ పైన గవర్నమెంట్ చెప్పింది ఇంత డబ్బులు అలాట్ చేసింది బడ్జెట్ లో పెట్టింది అన్నంత మాత్రాన ఇది సేంద్రీయ వ్యవసాయం జరుగుతుందంటే మాత్రం 100% జరగదు మెయిన్ క్షేత్రస్థాయి నుంచి బోల మా పల్లెలే ఈవెన్ నేనుండే పల్లెలే ఫస్ట్ మేము మా టిమ్మక్క కలెక్టర్ ప్రవేశపెట్టినప్పుడు మేము సేంద్రీయంగా చేస్తామంటే ఏందయ్య సేంద్రీయంగా చేసేదాన్ని చాలా మంది చూసిన వాళ్ళు ఉన్నారు అట్లాంటప్పుడు గవర్నమెంట్ ఓవరాల్ గా గవర్నమెంట్ ఒక సంస్థ తీసుకొని బాధ్యతగా తీసుకొని వచ్చి చేసింటేనే మేము 8 ఏళ్ళకి 10 ఏళ్ళకి ఈ లెవెల్ కు వచ్చినాము అట్లాంటిది గవర్నమెంట్ ఈ రోజు ఊరికే బల్క్ గా తీసుకొని 10 కోట్ల బడ్జెట్ కేటాయించేసి సేంద్రీయంగా చేయకోండి అంటే అది అసంభవం 100% జరగదు అని నా ఒపీనియన్
ఐ వుడ్ లైక్ ఫార్మర్స్ హియర్ టు ఆన్సర్ హీ సెడ్ దట్ యు ఆర్ గివెన్ ఇన్సెంటివ్స్ ఫర్ డిఫరెంట్ క్రాప్స్ ఇన్ డిఫరెంట్ పర్సెంటేజెస్ రైట్ హీ సెడ్ మిలెట్స్ విల్ గెట్ మోర్ 5 రూపీస్ అండ్ రైస్ విల్ గెట్ ఓన్లీ 2 రూపీస్ ఓకే హౌ డిడ్ యు అగ్రీ టు దిస్ Why did you agree to this? And what made you agree to it? It's my question.
సమానంగా పంచదానికి ఇదైతుంది అని చెప్పేసి అంటే మార్కెట్ లో కూడా చిరుధాన్యానికి ఉంటుంది మన చెనక్కాయకి 2 రూపాయలు ఎందుకు పెట్టినా అంటే ఫస్ట్ ఇచ్చింటాం అన్నమాట దానికి రేటు చిరుధాన్యాలకి అట్లా ఉండదు కదా దానికి రేటు ముందుగానే ఇచ్చేసింటాం రైతుకి దానికోసం దానికి 1 రూపాయి
One of the reasons that Swarnamma
Chenikkai ki rupai pettesi chirudanal 5 rupayalu endu pettaranu ante rate ante Chenikkai kompetitive especially mana Anantapuram jilla lo aa
ekkuvanta therefore we prefer to give more for the millets
chirudanal pai 5 rupayalu pettamo Chenikkai ki rupai pettamo
అది మేము డైరెక్టర్స్ నేను మాజీ డైరెక్టర్ని నేను మా డైరెక్టర్ గా ఉన్నప్పుడు కూడా ఇది రూల్ చేస్తామన్నమాట మేమే చేసిండేది ఫస్ట్ ఎందుకంటే ఈ చెనక్కాయ మీద ఎక్కువ మంది ఆధారపడ్డారు చెనక్కాయని తగ్గించాలా
మారుతీస్ ఆన్సర్ వాజ్ దట్ వి వాంటెడ్ టు హిస్ ఆల్సో ఎన్ ఎక్స్ డైరెక్టర్ ఆఫ్ ధర్ని సో వెన్ హీ వాజ్ డైరెక్టర్ ఆఫ్ ధర్ని వాజ్ ద టైమ్ వెన్ దే మేడ్ ద డిసిషన్ ఇస్ దట్ వి వాంటెడ్ టు పుష్ ఫర్ మోర్ మిలెట్స్ because everybody wants to grow groundnut and we wanted millets must be supported and therefore we decided to give a little extra for millets and less for groundnut because anyways people were growing hundreds of bags of groundnut they were not growing millets to support that we decided to give extra
చేసుకునే తర్వాతనే మనము ఆ నాణ్యానికి చూసి మనకు డబ్బులు కేజీకి ఇంత అని మనకు ఇస్తారు అన్నమాట వాళ్ళు మా అందరికీ కలిసి ఒక రేట్ చేసి చెనక్కాయకేమో రూపాయలు ఈ ధాన్యానికి వచ్చి సామాన్లు కానీ కొర్రలు కానీ ప్రతి ఒక్క దానికి కూడా
షీ సెడ్ దట్ ఈవెన్ ఐ వాట్ ఐ డూ ఈస్ దట్ ఐ సేవ్
ఉద్దేశంతో ఈ రైతులకి మా యొక్క సంస్థ టింబర్ ట్రీ సంస్థ ఒక పద్ధతికి అందరికి న్యాయం చేయడం ఉద్దేశంతో ఈ విధంగా తీసుకొచ్చింది ఎప్పుడైతే వీళ్ళు ఈ విధంగా తీసుకొచ్చిన తర్వాత ఏంటంటే మా సంస్థ తీసుకొచ్చిన తర్వాత పశువులకి మేత దొరుకుతా ఉంది
So, he said one of the decisions that we have taken, the reason why we have taken this decision is because we will be able to get the small farmers to earn some more money that they will not get towards this reason. Therefore, this kind of a decision because to grow millets, the capital expenditure is much lower. So therefore the failure so
how do you monitor the less. Farmers like they are really that's really why we have mechanism for monitoring the farmers
సంఘంలో 15 మంది ఉంటారు సభ్యులు ఆ 15 మందిలో మూడు భాగాలకు 5-5 మందికి ఒక లీటర్ ఉంటాడు మేమంతా పొలం పడి పంటలకు పోతాం అక్కడ పీల్ చేసేస్తాం ఏం పొలంలో ఏం తెగలు ఉంది ఏం కథ వీడు సక్రమంగా సేంద్రీయంగా చేస్తా ఉన్నాడా లేదా రసాయనాలు వాడుతున్నాడా కషాయాలు కొడుతున్నాడా మేము 5 మందే గుర్తిస్తామండి వారు చేయకపోతే మేము వారి సంఘం నుంచి తీసేస్తాం మేము అట్లా చేసి మేము సంఘం నింపులు చేసుకుంటూ పోతున్నాము మీరు అది ఇంతే కాదు అగ్రికల్చర్ డిపార్ట్మెంట్ లేదు పిలిపిస్తుంది కావాల్సి చెప్పాను మామూలు చదువుకోకుండా ఆటలతో పెట్టిస్తాం ఏ కషాయం ఎంత తయారు చేయాలా ఎన్ని కషాయాలు పంచపత్ర కషాయం దశపత్ర కషాయం తెల్లమాయలు కషాయం పచ్చిమిర్చి కషాయం ఈ కషాయాల గురించి వాళ్ళు చెప్పలేరు అది మా వాళ్ళే చెప్పాలి ఎందుకంటే మాకు అనుభవం ఉంది చేసినాము పెట్టినాం ఇది మా విజయం ఇది
ఇక్కడ మేమంతా చిన్న చిన్న రైతులు ఇక్కడ ఈ బీజేసిన సంఘాల ద్వారా ఏం చేస్తారంటే మేము దాదాపు 20,000 ఎకరాలు పెట్టుబడి పెట్టి పంట పెట్టినాము మేమేమన్నా పొరపాటు చేసినట్టే ఈ సంఘాల ద్వారా మొత్తం రిజెక్ట్ చేస్తారు రిజెక్ట్ చేసిన తర్వాత ఏమైతే వాళ్ళు మా పంట కొనరు అక్కడ మేము కాకినాడ కాంతనాడు కూడా రాకుండా పోతుంది కాబట్టి మేము ఖచ్చితంగా ఆర్గానిక్ పని ఆధారపడే పంట పెట్టాం ఇది మా పైన నమ్మకంతో వాళ్ళు విశ్వాసంగా
Understand. What they only describe the PGS system. In the PGS system, the sanghas, there are 15 members in each sangha, and each sangha has got 3 brundams, and each brundam has 1 leader. And these 5 people, or 5 families, they monitor each other. So PGS is a participatory guarantee system of organic certification. Which we are one of the founding members, and this is all over the country, and we use PGS system to certify. So we have also got the third party certification people to come here and audit our system, and you will be surprised to know that through the PGS system 743 people were certified as organic, 743 farmers under the third party system 920 farmers were certified. So PGS is a very good system because everybody knows what happens in the village, so nobody can fool anybody in the village. Everybody knows everything. So sometimes it happens that a farmer is actually organic, but his cousin or her cousin has come from some other village, has got seen the panda and has got certainly very scared, and in the night gone and put fertilizer. They catch them and then they are removed. Removed means they don't get, and it takes 3 years to get full certification. So no farmer member wants to do that. If once the certification is gone, then 3 years they cannot sell their product. So it's over.
నేను శ్రీకృష్ణ సేంద్రియ వ్యవసాయ సంఘంలో లీడర్గా ఉన్నాను అనమాట. మా సంఘంలో 15 మంది సభ్యులు ఉన్నారు. 5-5 మంది కలిసి ఒక గ్రూప్ అనమాట. బృంద సభ్యులు అంటారు. 5-5 మంది ఒక బృందం అనమాట. దగ్గర దగ్గర చేయడం అంతా కలిసి ఒక బృందం ఉంటారు అనమాట. 5-5 మంది సభ్యులు అంతా కలిసి దగ్గర దగ్గర చేయడం, మనము దగ్గర చేయడం, ఎవరు ఏం పంట పెట్టాడు, ఏం రసాయనం వేసినాడా, దిబ్బరి వేసినాడా, జీవామృతం వేసినాడా తెలిసిపోతారు అనమాట. అది యూరేసినాడా, డిఏపీ వేసినాడా, మామూలుగా కషాయాలు పడినాడా, రసాయనాలు పడినాడా, యూరియా వేసినాడా, దిబ్బర వేసినాడా, ఇవన్నీ కూడా
తెలుసుకోవడం. And everybody in the Sangam, in the Brundam knows what the other is doing, and we do the, we go and do the checking, and then we all take a pledge, and that pledge is very important, because in that pledge we vow that we will not use chemicals, and once we have taken that pledge, it is a promise, so of course we do.
వ్యవసాయం చేస్తామో అనే కొన్ని కొన్ని సిద్ధాంతాల పైన మేమంతా కలిసి మేము ముందుకు ఒప్పుకొని దాని ప్రకారంగా దాన్ని దిద్దామంతే తప్ప వేరే ఇట్లా రసాయనం కానీ కషాయం వాడడం
ఓకే. సో లేడీస్ అండ్ జెంటిల్మెన్, థ్యాంక్ యూ వెరీ మచ్ ఫర్ బీయింగ్ హియర్ విత్ us.